Praise the Lord, everyone. This is Pastor Rodney Smiling coming to you again with more instruction from God's Holy Word and your daily drive-by. Yeah. Listen, I want to talk to you all today about laziness and the opposite of that, or being proactive or being diligent. The Word of God says in Proverbs, chapter, I believe it's chapter 12, it says that lazy people will not even cook the game that they catch. It says, but the diligent make use or good use of everything they find. I remember when I was a boy, my mother was, you know, very innovative. She was very creative and just, you know, she had this mind that would take something that is of no use according to its original intent and use it for something else. So I remember, you know, in the backyard, she used to have, like, you know, let's say if there was a flat tire, right? She would take the flat tire and cut it in half, invert it, and then make it into a pottery, you know? It was amazing the things that my mother used to do growing up that I used to see her doing. And here it is at this age where I am now, I find myself doing some of the same things, you know, getting something and making it being used or using it for multiple uses, you know. And it's amazing. That's what the Word of God says the people of God do. We know how to creatively take nothing and make it into something. And why shouldn't we? Because our Father, our God, He stepped out into nothing and He spoke something from nothing. And so equally so, my friends, we need to be very careful. You hear me often tell you that you need to be careful of the words you speak, the things you say. You know, I hear people online, you know, for the longest you've been praying for a job, and then God bless you with a job, but you're complaining that everything is not perfect with the job. I mean, you know, we have to be very careful, because the words we speak actually will produce our environment. And so it is so vitally essential for us to make sure that we make good use of everything. Make good use of your time. Make good use of your body. Make good use of your health. Make good use of your money. Make good use of everything. I know right now we're in the Christmas season, and so often so many people go into debt because they're buying so many stuff, and then later on you find yourself complaining that you don't have enough money. Make good use of everything, because if you don't make good use of it, if you're not diligent with what you have, then in essence, you're lazy. In essence, you're lazy and you just want a quick rich scheme. You want to you want it now. You don't want to wait for nothing. You don't want to. Imagine preparing a meal that you don't wait for. Imagine putting something in the oven, chicken or steak, or you're frying this or frying that or baking this, and you decide, I don't feel like waiting the required time. I want to just get it now. No, don't be lazy. Everything, diligence and patience. The Bible says, let patience have her perfecting work. And then when it is done, you will be complete and entire, lacking nothing. We, the people of God, should never be anxious for anything, the Word of God tells us. It tells us, don't be anxious for anything, but in everything, through prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving for what you already have, make your request known unto God. And He's able to do it. And remember, God always does things at the right time, in the right season, in the right way. Remember, God's will done God's way never lacks God's provision. And so it is imperative for us as people of God to settle back and to be diligent with everything that we do. Because if we are diligent, the Word of God says, if you see a person diligent in their works, it will put them before great men. And so I'm here to tell you, you got to be diligent. You got to be steadfast. The Bible says, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know, your labor is not in vain in the Lord. So it is so important for us as people of God to be diligent, to be faithful, to be steadfast, to be unmovable, to be learning, that we grow in the knowledge and the understanding, and that we ask God, before we are looking to consume things upon things, ask God, God, what do I have? You know, the other day, and I'll share this last thing with you, the other day I was sitting in my room and I was working on a project and I needed something, and I remembered that probably a year or so earlier, I had purchased something for my digital camera because I take photos a lot. And I had purchased something for my digital camera because I was on a trip and I wanted something to hold the camera, and I wanted a mini tripod. And I purchased this mini tripod, but the one that I purchased, it was inexpensive, and it was too light to hold my digital camera, because my digital camera is a professional digital camera. And so it was too light to hold it. But then the other day, when I was working on a different project and I had this microphone thing that I needed a stand for, come to find out that the threading in the microphone was the same as in this mini tripod. And I was able to take that and use it versus going out there and buying something else. So I'm here to tell you, people of God, you know, check what's in your house. You know, one of the most important questions that have ever been asked to me is when God told Moses, I want you to deliver the children of Israel from Egypt. And Moses said, how can I do that? And God says, what is in your hand? What is in your hand? I want to ask you today, what's in your house? What's in your hand? What has God already given you that you can use to not only bless your life, but to bless others? I'm telling you, if you search diligently, and if you sort, organize, get rid of some of the clutter in your house, you're going to find that if you be diligent with it, that God is going to bless you abundantly. You're going to always be on top and never be with lack. God bless you. Have a marvelous day.